Māori na whānau. So it's Friday morning, it's the 4th of August. So from tomorrow, I'll be officially 7 weeks out from my next show, the Dubai Pro. I didn't get the best sleep last night, guys, to be honest. My sleep gets really bad going into sort of the last 8 weeks of prep. I don't know what it is. It's a combination of excitement, and my body wants to eat more than it wants to sleep. So it's silly because obviously sleep is so important for recovery, for fat loss, for muscle growth, you know, all the good stuff. So what I try to do is I'll try to take naps, you know, might be a 1 hour nap throughout the day or 2 hour nap sort of thing, when I can and when my body feels like it needs to. So yeah, I think I got to sleep at about, probably I fell asleep at like 11:30 last night. Obviously was up late, still doing work, and yeah, I crashed out. I honestly would have woke up at about 3 a.m. So the time is currently 3:48 a.m. and I'm getting my first meal in already. So yeah, I'll do a bit of mahi after this in the office, and then I'll get on the treadmill and do my cardio. Man, I just noticed my cheeks are already sinking in, guys, and I've still got 7 weeks. Sheesh. That's when I know I'm getting lean. I'm getting to that point where where conditioning really starts to come in. So considering I've still got 7 weeks, we're gonna be pretty freaky, guys. Which is the goal. I need to be as lean as I possibly can. So yeah, I did actually come off a high carb day yesterday. So Cuts gave me a high carb day. So at the moment, we're taking it week by week, but normally it's usually about one high carb day a week now. He's dropped that down. It used to be two. So yeah, I'm getting one of those in a week. And I'm pushing in a lot of food on my high carb days, guys. So on my next one, I might do a day of eating actually, and then I'll show you what I eat on a high carb day, and then I'll obviously show you what I eat on a normal standard day. So yeah, that I'll drop that soon, guys, maybe on the next episode, eh? But yeah, I always find after a high day, fuck, my appetite just goes through the roof. So yeah, I'm super hungry already, but yeah, it is what it is. And you know, you've got to embrace everything, you know, embrace the hard days, embrace the struggle, because you know that's when the magic happens. So yeah, I will, plans for today is, being Friday, so I'll head into the office shortly and get some mahi done. We've got a lot of things going on behind the scenes with AMF guys in our business. A couple projects that we've been really focusing on and working on over this, probably since the end of last year. So no one even realizes this, but yeah, we will be launching a few exciting things very soon, so stay tuned for that. But it has required a lot of our time and effort. So just trying to get these things, these projects up and running. But it all is going to plan, guys, and it's looking epic. So we can't wait to launch these projects very soon. So I'll be going into the office to chip away at that, and then for an hour or two, and then I'll go get my cardio done. And then yeah, obviously a bit more work today, this morning, to do a few updates, programs to do, get done before the weekend. And then I am catching up with a good mate of mine, Hamish, for a train today at 1 p.m. so I'll take you guys with me and film that workout for you guys. We're gonna hit back today, so yeah, I'm really looking forward to that. Hamish is an absolute monster. I started working with Hamish last year, so we did our first season together last year, and he did extremely well. He had a lot of time off from bodybuilding, competing, but he has come from powerlifting, so he's got a huge powerlifting background. I'll do a bit of an interview with him later on today, guys. But Hamish is he's an incredible guy. Literally, he's got some New Zealand records in powerlifting. He's a very, very sharp business-minded guy as well. He's had a lot of success with business over the past 10 years. So yeah, I'll get him on here and we can sort of dive a little bit deeper into Hamish's his experiences with business and bodybuilding and powerlifting. So stay tuned for that. And that's pretty much it, guys. See you soon.
Luca, what are you doing under there, my bro? Hello? Say hello to the fans, bro. You got a lot of fans on here. Luca, don't be shy. Oh, hello, Neo. Where'd you come from? Huh? Where'd you come from? To the king. You have a good sleep, bro?
This fire is incredible, guys. The boys love it. It just heats up the space so nicely. Especially because it's freezing. It is freezing here in New Zealand at the moment. Obviously we're in winter, so it's super cold, but yeah, that fire is a lifesaver. Honestly, the most affectionate cats you'll ever meet. I think all British Shorthairs are the same, or like they have that same sort of character, but yeah, especially our boys, like, wow, they're like dogs, like they're so affectionate. They're incredible cats, guys. British Shorthairs, honestly, they're not your normal cat. These guys are like, they're like kids, literally. They love affection. They show a lot of affection. And they just want to be around you, be on you. This guy, literally, Luca, he will follow me everywhere. Literally, like, if I go to the toilet, he'll follow me to the toilet. And he'll literally, like, wait outside the door for me. Like, and just never wants to leave your side. So at the moment, guys, for cardio, I'm doing 30 minutes on the incline treadmill, as you can see. Gradient 12.5 and speed 4.5. So for me, this gets my heart rate around that 120, 125 mark BPM. So that's a good spot for me to sit in. But everyone's different, guys. So you've just got to adjust the intensity to suit, to just keep your heart rate in that targeted fat burn zone. So
just got 20 seconds left. And then that will be me, that will be my cardio done for the day. I'm doing this six days a week, guys. 6 days a week, so yeah.
Guys, look at this beautiful sunrise. Look at that. Bit of frost on the ground down there. It is freezing. I'll tell you that much, but it's gonna be a beautiful day here in Tauranga.
Just making my pre-workout meal, guys. So I've got 60 grams of rice flakes.
And I'll just pour hot water over the top there. I just let that sit for a couple minutes just to soak up. So once that's rested for about 2-3 minutes, guys, I add my protein. So I'm using the Ghost Whey, the new flavor Cinnabon. It is unreal. So I add a scoop of protein. Just make sure that the scoop's nice and level, and also I add about another half, so a scoop and a half of whey. To be fair, guys, I would actually weigh my servings if I was you, or if you're starting out, because I'm obviously really good at eyeballing my portion sizes now after doing this for years, many years, so I'm always very accurate, but yeah, others might not be, and it's very easy to overdo the protein or underdo the protein when you are using a scoop. So yeah, just a little tip, just give that a mix in. And I add my good old peanut butter. I have 16 grams of this bad boy. Definitely make sure that you guys are weighing your peanut butter, because it's obviously a very dense calorie, being a fat source. Okay, so yeah, you don't want to overshoot on that one. There is my pre-workout meal. Check this guy out. You in a good spot, bro. 7 sunbathing, eh? Having a good time in the sun, my boy. That's the one.
Keys, wallet,
my godson Elijah and a little girl named Corinne. Some say the black of the better, the sweet
of the juice. I save the dark of the flesh and the deep of the roots. I give a holler to my sisters on welfare. Tupac cares if don't nobody else care. And I know they like to beat you down a lot. And when you come around the block, brothers clown a lot. But please don't cry, dry your eyes, never let up. Forgive but don't forget, girl, keep your head up. And when he tells you you ain't nothing, don't believe him. And if you can't learn to love you, you should leave him. Cause sister, you don't need him. And I ain't trying to gas you up, I just call him how I see. You know what makes me unhappy? That when brothers make babies and leave a young mother to be unhappy. And since we all came from a woman, got our name from a woman, and our game from a woman, I wonder why we take from our women, why we rape our women, do we hate our women? I think it's time to kill for our women, time to heal our women, be real to our women. And if we don't, we'll have a race of babies that will hate the ladies that make the babies. And since a man can't make one, he has no right to tell a woman when and where to create one. So will the real men get up? I know you're fed up, ladies, but keep your head up.
The big man himself.
Up the camera. What's up, buddy? How you been, right?
Yeah, all good, man. Good.
Hamish Coulter, ladies and gentlemen. Look at the size of him. Let's go.
as deep in the ocean, but my head is high in the sky. An angel's calling me over, but my feet won't take me that high. Grounded in my emotions, but I'm rising into the light. My spirit cannot be broken, now my heart's ready to fly.
Thank you. Guys, Hamish has come from a powerlifting background. You got a few national titles, bro. Do you want to?
Yeah, I've got three overall national titles and three or four bench press titles.
Shit.
And I went to Serbia 2016.
Wow.
And at the GPC Worlds and got second.
Crazy, crazy.
That takes a bit of a toll on the body, eh?
Yeah,
pretty big.
Yeah, yeah.
So I decided to get back to my roots.
Yeah.
About 15 years ago, I used to compete in bodybuilding. That's where I started. It was just in my off season. Then I did a powerlifting comp, and I said I was going to come back. It took 10 years, but here we are. So
that's the one, bro. Yeah. What were your sort of total lifts? What did you get up to, bro?
My squat was 365, so 300 pounds. Bench 230. So just over 500 pounds, and my deadlift was 325. So best total was 912.5, which is just over 2,000 pounds.
That's incredible.
Which at the time was incredible. More impressive because there wasn't many guys sort of
Yeah.
Now it seems like every 19-year-old on Instagram is doing it, but
back then it was solid though, bro. Yeah, that's incredible, guys.
Thanks, bro.
See, a lot of people don't know this, but Hamish was actually the owner of Muscle Fuel. New Zealand here. Do you want to touch on that, bro?
About 11, 12 years ago, I was a bodybuilder, and like all bodybuilders, I needed to prep my meals every day. And I'd find a company out there that could make my pre-made meals for me, but there was no one around that.
There was no one. I remember.
I'll do it myself.
Yeah.
So I hired a building and turned into a production kitchen, and we started making pre-made meals, and we had a lot of feedback in different areas we could move into. One of the big ones was our 10-week challenge, which we eventually turned into a keto challenge.
Wow.
And we had amazing results, and the business just surged from being, I think I had about 5 or 6 staff to start from, to over 100.
Wow.
We had multiple locations. We were pumping out like million meals every 6
crazy.
Months or so.
Yeah. I remember at the time because I was actually looking for a meal prep company at that time as well.
Yeah.
It was nothing else there like it, guys. And I remember Muscle Fuel was just dominating the space, and the food was really good quality too. It was top quality food.
We spent a lot of R&D
perfecting
that, and like as I say, no one was doing it at the time.
So yeah.
And there was a lot of companies that
huge point of difference.
Saw what we were doing and they wanted to get involved. So yeah. We actually ended up, the master company was Ready to Eat. We were manufacturing pre-made meals for the likes of HelloFresh, My Food Bag, Hams,
yeah.
And brands through supermarkets and
yeah.
Gas stations. And,
yeah.
But wow. All things must come to an end. I got bored.
Yeah.
And sold the company and yeah.
Fair enough, yeah.
Lots of new things.
Yeah. Massive, bro.
So babe brought home a new drink, guys, new energy drink. What is it?
Star Refresh. Summer fruits.
Summer fruit flavour.
Zero sugar.
Zero sugar.
155 megs of caffeine. So they'll perk me up for the afternoon.
That's a bit of caffeine, eh?
Yeah.
But no sugar, guys, so.
So good.
Verdict. Good, good.
That is good. That is so nice.
Interesting.
Yep.
Mmm.
Fruity.
That's fruity. Sort of reminds me of something. What does it remind me of?
I think it reminds me of an alcoholic drink. Like a cruiser. But like that passion-y.
Yeah.
Like that passion-y fruity one.
Yeah, it does, but but good, yeah, yum. Definitely nice. That's a, that's the one.
Good.
What's going on out here? Jesus. There's a big truck with a whole lot of dirt.
That is not for us.
That is not for us. It must be the neighbors. Check that out. That is a lot of dirt. Wonder where it's going.
What's going on out there, bro?
Please don't hit our new fence. Just got this privacy screen up, guys. This privacy fence there. Thanks to my brother Nath at Out the Gate Fencing. So he just chucked that up. When was that put up, babe? Last week?
Yeah, week before.
Week before. Did a really good job.
And this is what our afternoons look like because I'm so screwed for my training session. I need like a good hour or so to recover afterwards. Did legs today and it was my third leg session this week, so it was rough.
What are you doing up on the bench,
get
bar?
Get down, please.
Luca.
Get off.
You shouldn't be up here, bro.
Get down.
Come on.
You know.
You know. Look at him, he knows. Up down, bro. Come on.
Good boy.
We're teaching our boys better habits, eh? Because last, at our old house, they would always jump up on the bench.
Yeah, hated it.
So, they're learning slowly.
Good boy.
Neo's good, eh?
Yeah, Neo
doesn't do it. But Luca, he used to always jump up on the bench top, though. That's why.
Yeah.
He's getting there. Just got to keep telling him.
Hey guys, just thought I would let you know where I'm at. So I've got 3.5 weeks left of my shred. This is what I'm eating. Some eggs, piece of toast with some peanut butter and jam. Nothing fancy, but it does the trick. But yeah, things are going well, training's going good. Just changed into a new training program, so that's been fun. It's a lot more intense, higher intensity, and yeah, still just trying to push through, keep going, eat the foods, getting a little bit hungry, but as we know, it's all part of the process. Just wanted to add, I have no idea how Ash holds this camera up like this all the time because it is so heavy. I literally have to use two hands. But I also just wanted to say as well, he's just having a little nap on the couch at the moment because he was up at like 3 a.m. this morning just working because we've got a lot going on behind the scenes for ENF at the moment, which is very exciting. But yeah, he's smashing his prep and I am very proud. So I can't wait to see the end result when we get to Dubai. And I think we leave in 6.5 weeks now. So it is closing in, but very excited.